Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My title of the talk is Fringe Printer for Computer-Generated Holograms, and my name is Hiroshi Yoshikawa from Nihon University, Japan. So before my talk, I would introduce my university. Nihon University is established in 1889, and it's a private university and the largest university in Japan. We have 100,000 students, including high school students and elementary school students. And we have 14 colleges and more than 20 campuses spread mainly around Tokyo. And our college is a college of science and technology, just single college, but has 10,000 students. Okay. And this is just a photograph of our campus. And here is a list of my research project. I'm working on the lenticular 3D portrait system, and I'm mainly working on the digital holography, computer-generated hologram, fringe printer for CGH. Fringe printer is today's topic. And I'm also working on holographic video system and the simulation of the image reconstruction. And of course, I'm working on the optical holography, but still a main topic is digital holography, but I'm enjoying work with optical holography. And sometimes I support artists to make their holograms. Okay, here I have three color lasers, so I can make full color hologram, but I know it's very difficult, hard work. And I also have the pulse laser. Actually, it's Giora's camera, so even I can make a portrait. And here I would talk about the fringe printer. Here is the optical hologram. As you might know, that the hologram record intensity and the direction of light employing interference. And here is the how to compute the Fresnel hologram. It's just simulate a physical phenomenon in computer. And in our case, we assume that the object is the, collection of self-illuminated points, and so we can easily calculate the wavefront from single point. Then we sum up all points, then we get hologram. Okay, digital holography, it's very simple, just replace a film to the electronic device, but the requirements are very high. We need ultra high resolution, as same as the wavelength of light. It means that we need a device which with the less than 1 micron pitch. And of course, we need to handle the huge number of sampling points. Okay, let's assume our pixel is 1 micron, and our hologram is 100 millimeter by 100 millimeter. Then it means that we need a 10 gigapixel. So it's kind of challenging. We still need a lot of work. And here I want to basically briefly talk about holographic video display. As you know, that the Professor Benton's group at MIT proposed the holographic video system in 89. And at that time, I was a visiting researcher at his group, and I was in charge of the computation of the holographic fringe with the supercomputer. But today, I'm using, this is our holographic video system. It's very simple. We just buy a video projector and remove projection lens and the lamp, then replace the lamp with the white LED. Then I can get a hologram image with the video projector. Actually, as you can see, of, yeah, it worked. Okay, here is a liquid crystal, so the you can see the holographic image here. So this is specs of liquid crystal. It has a resolution of the SXGA and 10.4 micron pitch. Then okay, I put a white light LED. And we just use prisms and dichroic mirrors to separate RGB and also to combine the three programs. So here you can see the full color image. This is the CG model, and this is the photograph of reconstructed image. So this is hologram. On screen it's 2D, but it's 3D. And okay. I will show you the video. I'm not sure it works. Oh, maybe the codec is different, but actually, yeah, it doesn't work. Oh, yeah, it works. Okay. This is the display the image on the holographic television. Actually, it's he's dancing, and this hologram is calculated and displayed in real time. I'm afraid I use a strange codec.
So it drag the file to the desktop.
A desktop? Okay.
Yeah, drag the file to the desktop. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it worked. Oh, stop. Okay, he's dancing like this. Then I would show you another animation from okay, this is another animation. This is the sequence of the animation. So this is loads and blooming and the this is also calculated in real time and displayed in real time and 3D, but our liquid crystal is very small, and also the viewing angle is very narrow, so we cannot see the image with both sides, only the monocular observation, but at least we can get the real time calculation and display the program. So here is a conclusion of the holographic video. So full color and full parallax holographic video display can be technically realized, but with just one liquid crystal or three panels for full color, image size and viewing angle is very small. But if we can buy, say, 100 or 1,000 of the liquid crystal, then we can make image larger, but the cost is matter. Yeah, and so I think some breakthrough on spatial light modulator is required. So now I would talk about fringe printer. So this is the photograph of fringe printer. It's very simple. It has laser, projector, and XY stage, and some optics. It's very simple. And the motivation of our fringe printer is Okay, today, calculating gigapixel CGH becomes easy, even with your personal computer. You can calculate the huge pixel hologram. And, okay, for mass production, electron beam printer gives excellent result, but very expensive, so good for mass production, but not suitable for the small business or personal use. So I think compact and inexpensive fringe printer is desirable for small business and personal use. Okay, and here is the related works. As show you there, the holographic cellogram printer made by the many companies are already get a good quality, but our method is something different. So the other works are electron beam printer, and here is some works of holographic fringe printer. So this is the image, reconstructed image of the electron beam printer, electron beam lighting. So the pixel pitch is something like a 0.1 micron. And this is very interesting result. So the professor Sakamoto at Hokkaido University, Japan, modified the CDR lighter to light the computer-generated hologram. So this is the photograph of their hologram. Then this is the reconstructed image of hologram. Okay, since the hologram recorded in this CD, so the hologram looks like not square, but something like a fan. And, okay, and so Professor Matsushima at Kansai University developed fringe printer. Actually, they print point by point, so it is very time consuming. So he modified. So next, he used a rotating drum to light the dot pattern. And this is our system. We use a liquid crystal, and here is a laser, so we illuminate the liquid crystal. Then here is the two lenses to demagnify. Okay, this is liquid crystal, then we demagnify the image of the liquid crystal, then expose on the holographic plate. Okay, here is how it works. Okay, so here is a fringe and demagnify on the on the plate, then expose and move stage, then next to exposure, next, then we can make a large hologram with small elementary holograms. And here is a history of development. Okay, in my mind, I started this project in 89, but actually we get good result within 5 years. So just last month we have developed Mark III type. So here is the pixel pitch is now 0.61 micron. The Mark II is 87, the Mark I is 1.33. The main difference is the liquid crystal. Okay, it's SVGA and SXGA, and it's a liquid crystal for high vision, HDTV. So here is some result. This is hologram, printed hologram, and this is a reconstructed image. And this is another result of the rainbow hologram, which has a 10 gigapixel. And here is some difference between Mark II and, okay, this is Mark II and Mark III. So the liquid crystal is different, and the recording wavelength is different. And also the pitch of the liquid crystal is different. Here is some result of Mark III. Okay, the pixel number is here. It is roughly 22 gigapixel. And the size is here. Actually, we use a 4x5 plate, so now the size is limited with the plate size. And this is printed hologram before bleach. And here is a reconstructed image. It's a laser reconstruction Fresnel hologram, very simple object. But the big difference, big difference is the printing time. Okay, here shows the printing time to print megapixel. Okay, so Mark II takes 1.7 seconds to print 1 megapixel, but now we can print 1 megapixel at 0.772 seconds. And here is a comparison with our system and the CDL, and single spot and drum. Okay, our printing speed is most or fastest, and the pitch is smallest, and the maximum pixel is largest. But we still need some modification with the quality, image quality. Here I want to show you the hologram. Okay, our fringe printer is different from stereogram printer. As the stereogram printer, you can only record stereogram, but our fringe printer can record any type of hologram. Here is some sample, Fresnel hologram or H1, rainbow, holographic stereogram, cylindrical hologram, and disk hologram. I'll show you some reconstructed image. Here, again, the reconstructed image of the rainbow hologram. But this is rainbow hologram, so okay. This is view from center, left and right, then you can see the different perspective. But this is rainbow, so if you move upside and down, then color changes. This is original data, computer graphics data. And we also record the cylindrical Fresnel hologram, not the multiplex hologram. So this cylindrical Fresnel hologram proposed by Tom Jones in 67, and the difference, big difference is full parallax. So here is optical cylindrical hologram. This is object, and this is the, here is a hologram and a reconstructed image. Recording is very simple. Just put laser beam, and then you can record the Fresnel hologram. And we calculate this hologram with a computer. I mean that we made a CGH of the cylindrical hologram. Here is some numbers. Okay, pixel number is very big. Actually, we make 4 holograms to make a single cylinder. So it must be more than 30 gigapixels. And here is an object. And I forget to bring video with me. So this is just single shot of the image. It is side face of the skull. But it has both horizontal parallax and even you can get vertical parallax. And that one is a single color, but we also make a full color cylindrical hologram combined with rainbow hologram technology. Okay, and if you use a single point as illumination, the image size is limited, so we use the collimated illumination, then image or hologram getting bigger. Because of the maximum diffraction angle here and here are the same, but the incident angle is smaller with the collimated illumination. So here is some parameters, and okay, this is object, and this is photograph of reconstructed image. This is, okay, the difference of the size is the same as the actual reconstruction size. So here is a point source reconstruction, and with the collimated reconstruction, you can get much, much bigger reconstructed image. And here, I would show you some result from this hologram. This is concept of this hologram. And here is some parameters. Actually, we just make H1 for the disk hologram. So making the H2, we just put the holographic plate, then transfer optically. Here is a deconstructed image from H1 or laser reconstruction. And this is the H2 with multicolor. I made two masters and transfer with green and red lasers. Okay. I also have a movie. Oops. Sorry. Actually, the image is very small, like roughly 10 millimeters diameter. And, okay. Actually, the size of, as mentioned, the image is this big, very small, but multicolor. Okay, one more. Small image. It doesn't work. Okay. So. Oh, in my kitchen. It doesn't work. Also, I made a stereogram. It's very small stereogram, and actually, I presented this result at Wales meeting. So, but we can still record stereogram. And this is the multicolor denisher. So the we print H1, and this is data, and this is reconstruction from H2. So the we optically transfer H1 to H2. Here is a conclusion of my talk. So the our system, fringe printer system, is fastest, finest, and the largest fringe printer. And we still need some luck to improve our image quality. And at now, we can record 22 gigapixel with 0.61 micron pitch. And the printed hologram is suitable for both the master hologram and direct viewing with white light. And this is just small advertisement. I wrote a chapter with this book, Digital Holography and Three-Dimensional Display. And the chapter title is Computer Generated Holograms for White Light Reconstruction. Okay. So that's all. And thank you for your attention.